back to our caterpillar. Visibly, things have not progressed a lot, but his skin is a lot looser. And if you can see how his body, how he's just kind of churning and doing his thing to get out of his skin. As I'm sitting here filming this, I've got a monarch butterfly, a female, flying around laying eggs. So we have plenty of these guys around here right now. They overwinter here in Florida. You've heard about the great monarch migrations. A lot of them go to Mexico, but we're plenty warm enough here. We've got a busy season. It's almost busier in the winter than it is in the spring. A little breezy today. I don't know if that's going to slow things down or not. Still seems to be doing okay. So maybe a good time to point out the different parts of the caterpillar. If you see it by the head, which is hanging down, he's got 6 legs, and then the other knobs that you kind of see on his belly, those are called pro legs. They're kind of like suckers that stick, like those sucker things you can stick on windows to hold things. That's kind of what they're like. They help him move and stick to plants and whatever he wishes to crawl on, like this chair. Really going at it now, see him? I encourage everyone to plant milkweed. Our monarch butterflies are in danger because of GMOs. Milkweed grows wild in the fields where the farmers are planting their corn or whatnot. And of course they spray massive amounts of Roundup, which is a weed killer. And it doesn't kill the crops because they're GMO, but it is killing the milkweed, which is the only plant that the monarch will lay eggs on. And then the caterpillars eat the plant and get into this stage then when there'll be a butterfly. They're really easy to grow. Most nurseries here in Florida sell them. Even Home Depot and Lowe's will sell them. There, see his green beginnings of the chrysalis are forming now. But it's really easy to grow. It doesn't take a lot of water. It does prefer part to full sun. Just throw some seeds. If after you get some, they'll have little seed pods. You collect the seeds and grow more. And just drive down the road and throw them out the door because these guys need us. I will add, if you're in a part of the country that you cannot locate milkweed, hit me up on, I'll send you some seeds. They do take quite a long time to get to a size to support a life, but I'm more than happy to send seeds. See the skin that he's gotten out of? See it kind of clumped up there at the top? There went the scan, dropped off. No, it's not done yet. It may look like he's not hanging on by much, but it is very, very strong. I forget what it's called, what he hangs by there. It's extremely strong. It's like super glue. He still has a little bit ways to go. He's starting to harden from the bottom. Basically, if you take what we're looking at now, there's his neighbor that's starting to do his thing. This is going to be the final form. Just a single gold ring at the top. You see how he still has several rings of gold. Needs to tighten up a little bit more. I'm just about to run out of room on this memory card, so I'm just going to tell you a fantastic Facebook page to go to is Shady Oak Butterfly. She's located here in Florida, but she shows you anything and everything about caterpillars, butterflies, moths, right down to even the diseases that they can get. And there's a website called Journey North, I think is the name of it, where if you're into monarchs like I am, you can actually post on there your sightings and kind of keep track of their migrations and where we're seeing the numbers. And I would eventually like to start tagging these guys so we can help out with their keeping them from going extinct. That would be a real shame. I also encourage you to not use Roundup in your yard. It's a horrible horrible, horrible product. It needs to be taken off the market. It's responsible for so many birth defects. And of course, it's in our food. Most of you know me, know I'm anti-GMO. The corn and the soy is rampant in our society and our processed foods. So don't eat them. You see right there, about in the middle, his gold ring has started. What he'll do is he'll tighten up a little bit more and bring that up to the top. If you look over here again, the one that's finished, so it's close to the top. Beautiful spot right now with the sun shining on it. Really shows up really good. It is blazing hot out here this morning.